Father before the creation, or there was Satan. The Son was with the Spirit and the Father in glorification. Before worship of angels from above, and the Holy Trinity's in a perfect triangle of love, shared with no one else, cause there's no need for others. God is self-sufficient, fulfilled within himself, and we can only guess the conversation. But the Son agreed to rescue those the Father gave him, and even though this Lord should have been worshipped, he volunteered to take upon the form of the servant. The Father commanded, yet asked him to come. So now let's examine the fashion this was done. Now let me ask you if you seem confused with this. God passed through his own creature's uterus, and I admit this is odd, but the Bible can persuade me. An omnipotent God crying as a baby. No doctors around, no spot could be found to give birth to a child. The only option in town was to be born in a feeding trough next to breeding cows and feces piles. Yeah, the scene was foul. It wasn't fancy, but raunchy. How the Son of God was born next to camels and donkeys. And what an awesome feat to drop so deep, to cop his sheep. He didn't step down, he took a quantum leap. And I'm amazed at God, infinite in wealth, set aside his fame and limited himself with time and space and eyes and legs. He died to save a violent race whose sin was gonna bring them hell. Who'd assume that this could be? God became a man, penetrating into human history, but he did it completely opposite than people thought he would, so they were mocking it. The promised Messiah didn't come in honor of Syra, but humbly rocking some modest attire. So people missed it. To be specific, the legalistic said that their king would be the richest. And I know we like commodities, but the possessor of all riches chose a life of poverty. Wait, this isn't the descendant of David, is this? Yes, and he's descended the greatest distance. He chilled with sinners and tax robbers, and amongst his creatures whom to him were grasshoppers. He dwelt with the lower class of blessed men, and those known as trash were his chosen kin. Well, the unbelieving Jews were sick of him. They said he runs with a team of stupid fishermen and speaks to Samaritans, and barbarians and Pharisees stared at him with harsh arrogance. And it's shown when the Savior took notice of beggars, healed the sick and the blind and those with the lowest of wages. He even touched those with leprosy, which was seen as the most disgusting known infection. See? Wait, are you kidding me?